If you're ready to get better insights into how your business is running, you are gonna love the new interfaces tool within Airtable. And specifically in this video, I'm gonna be drilling into how you can gain more insights from a particular record inside your database, but not feel excluded in working in your database. Instead, have it all in that beautiful interface dashboard. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. My name is Gareth Pronovost. I own Gap Consulting, and I am going to help you save up to 20 hours of your time every week using no-code tools and automation. If that's of interest and you want to learn more about how we help everyone achieve those kinds of amazing goals, you'll definitely want to check out my upcoming webinar. Once a week, I hop onto a live webinar and I showcase the building blocks of automation. So if you'd like to learn how to leverage the powerful tool of no-code automation, you don't want to miss that free training. You can sign up using the link below or visit me at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. And listen, I realize not everyone can make the live event, so of course I'm going to send you a replay if you sign up as well. But without further ado, let's hop into the actual heart of this video. I'm showcasing the new interface. Specifically, I'm looking at the record review. So when you go to set up a new interface, there are three different templates that you can start with. One of them is record review. One of them is dashboard. By the way, we've already recorded something about putting together a sales dashboard. Check out that video. I'll link to it up above somewhere. Then there's also the record summary, and you can start with a blank canvas. Now, in this case, I'm starting with that record review, but before we get into it, let's actually look at the underlying data. If you're new to the channel, you might not have heard me say this before, but this is mission critical, folks. You have got to have the proper data structure in your database before you can start building all the fun automations, all the fun interfaces. All of that stuff is secondary to proper data structure inside of your Airtable database. It might sound easier than it actually is. So let's go ahead and jump into this. We are looking at our projects, and we want to drill into our projects and get an oversight of what's going on with those projects. But the projects don't live in a vacuum, and that's the whole point of using a relational database. Here we have our projects, but you see that they're linked to tasks. And you also notice that they're linked to clients. So in the clients table, pretty simple, we've just got a few different clients with phone numbers. Over on the tasks table, we have a name for our task. Of course, it's linked to the project. And then there's a person in charge. In this case, this is just an example database, but you could share this with everyone else on your team who has access to your database. I also have a start date and an end date for each of my tasks. And I have a completed checkbox. It's pretty straightforward stuff for a standard tasks table. Now, those are the three tables that are going to come into play in this particular interface. So let's drop into the interface now and take a look at exactly what we've got. This is pretty slick, and I'm going to go through each of these different elements one by one so that you can add them to your own interfaces and so that we can all just get more education around what these interfaces are truly capable of doing. So on the far left, you'll notice I have the record picker option, and I can choose between my different projects. Now, the important thing to note here is that everything else on this interface is tied to whatever project I've selected. So this is all driven by whatever project I want to take a look at in that particular instance. As I click through the projects, you notice all the other stuff is updating as well. So pretty straightforward here. The next part is our client. We can drill in and see who the client is that's connected to that project. Now, of course, the client is always going to be different, and it's tying to a different table. And that's something that's maybe not intuitive when you go and you start to set up this record review interface, because it says here in the description that you can review details of many records from one table. But the truth is, all the records in that one table are connected to other stuff. And that's the whole power of Airtable to begin with. And thank goodness we can still bring all that power into our interface. So again, we're able to link to the client here. You also have the ability to see a project lead. In this case, this is my collaborator field type back in my database, and I'm bringing it out here so that I can see who's in charge of the overall project. I'm also looking at this overview. This is another field that lives in my projects table, so I can see what the overall project goals are. And then also the status of the project. Almost all projects have some sort of a status that goes and runs throughout the course of operation. And in this case, we have a bunch of different status: pending approval, development, deployment, support, and completed. So you may have more than this in your particular process, but I use a single select field for this to track exactly what stage a project is in at any point in time. Now, for the more fun parts, I have attachments, and these are our assets for the project. And the really nice thing here is we've got a little bit of a carousel, and we can actually scroll through the different photos that I've added to my database. Pretty slick. Also, I've mentioned this in a previous video, but I love having comments in the interface. The ability to see the record comments, whereas before we had to drill into the record and look at those comments, now we get them right here on the interface, smack dab in the middle of all of our work with this particular thing. I've also got tasks here, and these, if you recall, are what's linked to our project. So again, another linked relationship showing up here. I can drill into these tasks and take a look at what's going on inside of them. But a lot of that information is already showing up here, and this is all stuff that I can change or customize to my liking. Now, the last piece I've added here is the timeline. And this is just showing us a bit of an overall calendar-esque view. It's not a true calendar, but yes, it's giving me an overview of what my tasks are and where I am in the process. The really nice thing about this is I've actually altered it to show me with color visualization what tasks are complete and which ones aren't. In this case, all of these are showing up green, but if I flip to a different project, you'll see that some of these tasks are not complete, and that's denoted by the red color here. So really nice feature here, and again, I love all of the capabilities that interface has given us. Let's jump into the editing portion of this and look at how we set this all up. Clicking in the upper left, I can go to edit this interface. This piece right here, again, is a client, and this is a field linked to or connected to the record list. Remember, this sidebar over here on the left is where I get to pick the project. So everything else on this interface needs to be connected to that reference, because otherwise these elements won't make a whole lot of sense, because what we want to do is visualize the data that's connected to that particular project. So make sure that you're connected to your record list, and then you always have the ability to either see an element in view only or in editable mode. So if you click it to view only, it's just going to be a read-only interface, or you can give your users the capability of editing this data. You also have some size options here, default or pill, and lastly, you can choose to either show a label or not. I like showing the label so that I can see what that is. You don't have to go with whatever you've named that field. That is by default what that label will be, but you can come in here and change it. Maybe you want to say customer instead, and as I make those changes, changes show up on my interface. Also here with my project lead, very much the same. I've got attachment to a record list. Don't forget to connect there. And if I want view only or edit access here, I make that choice and whether or not to show a label and the size. Similarly, here I am in overview. Again, these are all elements that live in my projects table. So all I have to do is add access to that element. If you're not sure how to do that, check the bottom left corner and just bring in the element that you need. In this case, I'm just bringing in, again, connected to the record list, and I'm bringing in this particular field, the field called overview. Lastly, same thing with status here. I've got my field called status, relates to the project, and I'm bringing that in here. Now for the more fun stuff, I have my assets, and this is where I'm bringing in my different files. I have an attachment field inside of my projects table that I want to bring in here. So how do we do that? Well, add element, if you're doing this from scratch, bottom left corner, and inside of the option here of the record list, again, we want this to connect to the actual record that we're choosing from our projects on our left panel. Inside of that, you can scroll down and you'll see all the different fields that live in that particular table. In this case, my field is called assets. Because of the field type, because it's an attachment field, I have some different options here. You can install a carousel, which is going to be a number of different images or attachments in one place, or you can do the hero, which allows you to kind of scroll through like this. I preferred the hero, so I went with that here in this case. Now onto the next one. I've installed the record comments. Again, that's an element that ties to the projects. Over here, tasks. This is a linked relationship, but again, a field that lives in projects. So even though it's another layer deeper, in this case, projects links to tasks, I can still get access to it right here. And then lastly, I have my timeline down here. And this is a little bit unusual because it's looking at the timeline of the tasks. So if we drill into this just a little bit more, you can see that, again, connected to the record list, and I have to tell it where this information is coming from. In this particular case, I can drill this down, and you see that I'm looking at the record list of those things that are connected to my project in the tasks table, right? So it's that linked relationship between projects and tasks, and that's how I can bring this timeline in for my project. Then again, I set up all my different date settings. And the nice thing about the timeline view, if you're new to the timeline view, is that you get a lot of customization in how you visualize those on the timeline. So in this particular case, on the appearance section, I've said I want to bring in the name and the person in charge. And you can even add the italics or the underlining or the bold text that I've done here. I can include more information here if I want. I can show whether it's completed or not. I can show an end date, even though that's a bit redundant on a timeline. But all of this I can make visible in the actual displayed name of fields on the timeline. I liked it the way it was before. Actually, I don't even need person in charge because you'll notice I've grouped by the person in charge here on the left. And that, my friends, is done right here in the grouping section. So I've simply said I want to group by that person as well. So if I had multiple team members, I could collapse or expand their particular tasks in association with a particular project. I know there's a lot to wrap our heads around with the new interface tool, and I went quickly here. My goal was to showcase to you a lot of the new functionality in a very condensed time. So I hope that you take this and really run with it for your own interfaces and just build some really cool stuff to help you run a better business. If you liked this video, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel and give us a thumbs up. It really helps us with the YouTube algorithm so that we can be seen by more no-coders just like you. And I will see you in the next video.